Hi. This is kind of YouTube business in a way, I guess. In that I've been thinking recently about the fact that there are certain groups of people who set themselves up in opposition with other groups of people but don't actually talk with them in any way. They seek to ridicule them. Now, the groups that I'm referring to in this particular instance, because these are the groups that I've kind of been interacting with just very recently again, after all these years, are the atheists and the theists. And whilst there are a few people in both camps who are genuinely interested in talking with the people to whom they are kind of theoretically in opposition to, genuinely trying to understand, trying to find meeting places and opportunities for real communication to take place. By and large, it's people looking at the other group, calling them ridiculous, whether in an ill-informed or informed way or not, and comments are not from that other group. Comments are from, you know, they're preaching to the choir. They're preaching to the people who already see things in a fairly similar way to them. And because I don't really belong in either group, or I certainly don't consider myself to belong in either group, I've noticed I can go into each of them and I can say things which are a bit challenging about the methods that they're using rather than the actual content. And because they both use the same methods, which is, I find, really interesting. You know, they're more alike than they would like to think, a lot of these people. And what tends to happen when I do that, not exclusively, but often, is that I will get attacked. I will be misinterpreted, often interpreted as being part of the other group until I point out that, no, I'm not. But even when I point that out, I am still ridiculed or put down or told I'm talking absolute crap. Often in a quite negatively destructive way. In other words, you either are with us or you're against us. You can't possibly be outside of this dichotomy. You can't possibly not be part of this. Therefore, if you're not, you know, patting us on the head and saying, yes, aren't you wonderful and aren't you right, then you must be with the other group. But that's not the case. And it's so often so dismissive that it becomes completely purposeless to talk. You know, it's one of those lessons that I have to keep learning, because I like to talk with people, and I like to talk with people who don't necessarily agree with me, because it's interesting, but not so we can kind of lock horns and call each other names. Like, I can't be bothered with all that nonsense. So I do this, and then I realise, no, that really wasn't a good idea. Because, you know, quite often for days afterwards, you'll get these kind of condemnatory remarks in response to what you've said. And I mean, you know, it's not the end of the world. It doesn't really matter, I guess. But why bother? Why bother to engage with people who are so closed-minded that they make these huge and incorrect assumptions about people? Not only me, who's neither for them nor against them, is just interested in the topic in general, but the people who are against them. You know, if you want to change people's minds. Sorry, phone call about those beasties that I made a video about the other day from the Forestry Commission. Yay. If you want to change people's minds, don't attack them. Don't ridicule them. Don't behave in such a way that you shut them out. Otherwise, you may as well shut up. I mean, you know, obviously, if you want to go on and on and on and on about a particular topic to people who agree with you and it feels good, then I guess there's no reason for you to stop that. But it's not achieving anything in terms of changing anybody's minds. So it's an odd one, a very odd one. and a singularly unhelpful one. You know, as I said, it just, what it does is maintain the status quo, not changing it.